Hi everyone, this is Brendan here, and welcome to my next episode, day one of my Let's Clash series. So today we did a lot of upgrades. So as you can see, I'm upgrading Archer Tower right now. And then after that, I follow on by getting a lot of walls. I decided to get a lot of walls for myself because I really want to get this base up, not doing it like my second account, which is a defenseless account. So going for a raid, and then we're going for the Goblin map right now, Rocky Fort. It's quite an easy base to take on, to be honest, because you just have to deploy your Barbarians on the three cannons, and then after that, they'll be taken out. Once taken out, then after that, the Barbarians will just take out the whole entire base. Don't even need any air troops or whatsoever. In fact, at such a low Town Hall level, don't have any air troops to use. It'll be nice to have some archers to shoot over the wall. However, the Barbarians are strong enough to bust through the level 2 walls. So yeah, we have just gotten one of the achievement. Now, upgrading the storage, gold storage to the next level. Now proceeding on to the next things that I've done the whole entire day, getting more resources, going for an attack, and then after that finding a base to attack. So the same style as what I mentioned below, Bronze League, the bases are rather easy to take on, which is you just have to use your Barbarians or your archers if you have to just take out the cannons or the archer tower if there are actually defenses available. And then after that, they just tear through the base, not having other defenses to take them on. So just focus on defenses and you should be fine. No worries about that. So just fast forwarding a bit, don't have to watch the whole entire thing. Then just getting a 3-star very, very easily. So that's really nice. So let's take a look at what else I've done the whole entire day. So today, other than doing that, I've also upgraded my barracks to level 2 so that I could get archers. So archers are really neat. Especially they can shoot over the wall. So later I'll show you guys some raids with the archers. So as you can see, I found this 4,000 gold base. It's quite a large amount, to be honest, because I only have 7,000 gold capacity right now. So it's quite a lot, to be honest. So it's really nice to find 4,000 lying over there, especially when the storage is just exposed without any walls to protect it. However, this base was quite hard to take out the defenses earlier as mentioned, because the defenses are protected behind some of the other structures, so I couldn't score 100% for this, especially that particular archer tower on the right side that was giving my Barbarians a lot of pain, especially when now my army camp slot was only 20 until eventually I decided to upgrade it. So for the next few episodes, I'll be focusing more into explaining to you guys in detail. As for now, I'll just skip forward and fast forward almost everything, so that you guys don't have to wait too long and watch my whole progress of the whole entire day, and I can update you guys the whole entire procedure. So I was thinking to maybe make this series in such a way whereby I edit it in such a way I show you guys the important stuff instead of just showing you guys say 6 minutes or 10 minutes gameplay of how I play Clash. But of course, searching for the raids, this and that, I will try to skip it. Otherwise, we will just keep next and next and next, and after that, we will take a very long time to search for an attack. So yeah, the Goblin map just got taken down. Another 3-star, this base was quite easy, just using Barbarians should be able to get it down. And now we eventually upgrade our Town Hall to Town Hall 3. So getting to Town Hall 4 is my objective for now, so that I can focus a lot more on the video itself, so that I'll be able to show you guys more contents. Because from really Town Hall 2 to Town Hall 4 is really a no-brainer. You just have to do a little bit of raiding. After that, just upgrade whatever stuff that comes in the shop itself. So it's not too difficult. And then after that, now we'll go for another attack. So this particular attack, as you can see, I brought with me archers. I'll show you guys how I use it. Just sniping some of the structures outside first, so I get some of the percentages and hopefully not lose the raid. And then I tried to drop an archer over there to snipe that town hall, but got taken out by the cannon itself. So I wanted to get the gold because I was low on gold. So I decided to drop some Barbarians to break through the wall. Don't have wall breakers right now, so it's kind of difficult. Then after that, it just broke through the wall, got the storages, archers behind supporting. So the way how to use it is basically to have your Barbarians in front tanking the damage for the archers, archers behind shooting over the wall, and you should be fine. So basically, this is the basic method of how I farm. Eventually, I'll be using this method a lot because I love to farm with Barge and even Bam. Bam meaning Barbarian archers and minion. Barge is Barbarian and archers. So you guys will be seeing a lot of farming with this particular army's composition. So it's something you guys should actually learn too, because it, to me, it's the fastest way of farming. That's how I actually farm my base, my main account to a max Town Hall 10. So with even a cap 2 billion gold grab and 2 billion elixir escapade. So that's the cap for the whole entire profile itself. So yeah, getting a 50% 2 star for the attack itself. So I'll be teaching you guys how to farm properly, how to farm the best optimum manner. But of course, it takes a lot of effort and a lot of time to farm to a max base. So that I can't change our control. So yeah, we're going to upgrade our Archer Tower now. So upgrading it to level 2. Then after that, proceeding on to collect some more resources as I just got back online. After that, collecting more gen from the achievement. So hopefully be able to get all the achievement done. Maybe a war also I will try to do a bit. And then I did mention beforehand in my previous video that you guys should focus more on the storages, because storages are really important now. As you can see on the top right, my capacity is only at 7,000. And then to get a lot of resources into my capacity, my storages, is not really good, especially when I go and attack people, then it overflows. So getting more army camp, the things that you guys should focus on when going into a new town hall is those stuff that increase your offense, such as your army camp, such as your clan castle, and even your barracks. Especially if you're able to research to a higher level troop, which I'll talk about next time too, then you should actually upgrade it. So I was trying to get my research net, but eventually I did after reading for quite a number of times today. So this particular base was quite easy, just getting the archer towers down and then eventually just destroying the whole entire base with a whole group of barbarians and eventually getting us the 3 stars. So now we are back to our base again, and then eventually I got more army camp. So now I could build another new army camp because I reached Town Hall 3. And then my army camp is really important, to be honest. That's like the first few things you guys should be focusing on, because the more troops that you guys can actually have to go ahead and attack, you guys will be able to progress faster. So yeah, just proceeding on to upgrade other stuff such as the mortar itself. So the mortar, I will be trying to get it done because that's one of the important defenses at a low level for it being a splash damage, especially after that you will get wizard towers. These two are the ones that you kind of need to focus on when you're like a Town Hall 7 or Town Hall 6, because those are the ones that actually help to take out people who are using barbarian archers, etc., because they do splash damage, huge splash damage to those kind of troops. So yeah, just doing another raid. This was kind of easy attack using barbarian archers. So we are back to our base again, and this was taken the whole entire day. Now we are upgrading our army camp to the next level, and then eventually I went to do a few more raids. So yeah, basically as mentioned, this whole entire episode will be just fast forwarding here and there, here and there. I'm thinking to maybe do the whole entire series in such a manner so that you guys won't have to watch the whole entire process, just focusing on those main points as to how I farm my base, what things I focus on, and what kind of upgrade orders do I upgrade my defenses or even my structures, the whole entire base itself, and what kind of things I look out for, just small little tips here and there, rather than doing a whole entire live raid, like maybe a 30 minutes whatsoever gameplay, like some kind of live attack or whatsoever. I think that's not very feasible, so I'm trying to do it in such a way whereby I focus more important stuff so that you guys won't have to watch all those unnecessary clips. So yeah, we're back to our base. Achievement just unlocked, and then after that we just got 5 gems for the achievement. So achievements are really important, especially if you want to get your 4th and 5th builder. The 3rd builder is not very difficult to get because you have to remove obstacles, and you should be able to get it in a few days or weeks time. However, for the 4th and 5th builder, it's recommended to complete the achievement, especially the 5th builder. If you really do want to get it, it's better to complete the one with the league one, the one that if you achieve like a master league, you get 1,000 gems, and if you were to reach a champion, you would get 2,000 gems. So maybe I'll try to push this account to master league ASAP so that I'll be able to get the 1,000 gems and probably get the 4th or 5th builder. So yeah, as now you can see, I brought my account to the clan. I brought my account back to SG Gladiators. I managed to get the clan castle build up, and then I brought my account back using a Doctrine's account. I'm using Doctrine's account actually. So I brought it back, and then eventually I requested for some troops. So how we're going to increase the speed as to how we're going to attack even better also is to get minions for ourselves. So I did type there any troops is fine. But yeah, I tried to focus more on minions because minions are air troops. And if you were to use them, say at Bronze League or even in Silver League, some of those bases with just level 1 air defenses and maybe just one or two archer towers. You just have to use your ground troops to take those structures out. Eventually, you just drop your clan castle with 5 level 6 minions, and eventually, you just take out the whole base. So later, I'll show you guys some examples too, so that you guys can have a feel of how minions are really powerful at such a low league. So now we are just upgrading another gold storage. So as mentioned before, storages are really important to upgrade as soon as possible whenever you are able to. So yeah, now we are going for an attack with a CC of minions. So yeah, see, as mentioned, I try to take out the archer towers first. Once archer towers have gone down, you basically can just drop your clan castle. And then after that, the clan castle, the minions will actually just come out and take out whatever things that can't attack them. Especially like the cannons, where they could only attack ground troops. And then eventually the minions just fly over there and just take them out really quickly. So as you can see, we just scored 40%. Eventually taking out the town hall now. Then after that, just fast forwarding a bit, the minions flew all the way around and then just took the 3 stars for us. So yeah, that's really nice to have minions in the CC to try to attack those people in the lower league, because just the minions come out and you'll be able to take them out really easily. So upgrade the next storage right now, the gold storage. So I'm trying to upgrade a lot of the gold storages because I need more gold capacity so that I can upgrade my town hall level fast. Because you need gold capacity to be rather high so that you can actually upgrade your town halls. I kind of remember the amount because I did upgrade the town hall of my Brandon 2 account. I did rush the account because I knew that that was just going to be a defenseless account without any focus on defenses, walls or other structures, just focusing on offense and also just getting to town hall 9 or 10 as soon as possible. So yeah, this is just going to be another raid as to how the minions are really powerful. For those of you guys who are thinking like, how are you supposed to get minions, especially if you are in a, you just freshly started or whatsoever. Not to worry, you can just go to this clan called the 200 Club. And when you go there, you just request and they'll be able to give you troops such as level 6, 7 archers or even a level 5 or 6 minions. If you want, I'll put a clan tag in the description below. You guys can go and take a look at it. Other than the 200 Club, there are many other clans that you guys can go over there, like other clans such as Request, GTFO. So basically those clans are like donation clans. Basically if you go inside, they will donate troops for you, and then after getting the troops, you have to leave the clan, because that's how they increase and make the traffic flow. And then eventually when more people come in, they will just donate. The reason why they are doing this is because they want to increase their level for their account. So every one troop that they donate, say for example a barbarian, they get 1 EXP. If they donate a minion which actually takes up 2 housing space, they get 2 EXP. So those people, they are just giving out troops for free. You guys can go over there and take a look and check some of the clans out. So yeah, just removing some obstacles right now. Just fast forwarding everything a bit, just like some kind of time machine. And then eventually we just get another achievement done, getting 5 more gems. So we are at 307 gems now, trying to get 500 gems so that we can get the third builder. So the third builder isn't that too difficult to get, because 500 gems, honestly speaking, when you start off, you get like roughly 240 over gems. Just to get 260 gems, removing obstacles should be fine. And then eventually, when you get some of the achievement done, you will be able to get it. And then now getting more walls for the base itself, because I'm trying to get the walls, basically everything, maybe to level 9 or 10. Hopefully be able to get to level 11, because after the update, after the recent update of the ability to upgrade your walls using Elixir, definitely it's going to be easier to upgrade to level 10, 11. But as compared to last time when I played my max account, I could only upgrade using gold because Supercell didn't release that at the point of time. So I would say now farming is really easy because of the walls being able to use Elixir to upgrade, and also the costs have some of the buildings have also decreased, in taking into consideration that also the league bonus have also increased. So I explained and talk to you guys more about that soon. So once we reach to a higher league, so yeah, just doing more upgrades, more buildings. So as you can see, I got more elixir collectors, this and that. So the things you guys want to focus on are resources. As of now, trophies really isn't that too important, because you just want to upgrade your base so that it gets really strong. If you're going to like push all the way to say crystal league, which is at 4,000 trophies, and then you're going to have like, for example, my this base, when you log off, and you go on defense, people's just going to attack you, and probably, not probably, but highly, they're going to 3-star you. So it's not recommended to go to such a high trophy range if you are kind of low in Town Hall level. So kind of better to stay in Bronze League as for now for me. But eventually, once I reach to like Town Hall 9 or whatsoever, I'll proceed on to Crystal League. So now we are getting our research lab. So research lab is really important to get it as soon as possible because it adds another kind of like a builder to your whole entire base. So yeah, we're going to get another goblin map done. So cannonball run, this map itself, they are all only have cannons as defense, no archer tower, so they just drop the CC and it came out all the minions, 5 minions flying around taking out all the cannons, not doing a single damage to the minions at all. So as mentioned, cannons cannot attack air, however the minions can attack the cannons, so which is really nice to use them. So eventually when we are back to our base, we have slightly more resources, and then after that we are going to get some of the bombs, which are the traps. So traps are something that are hidden from your opponents. Your opponents cannot see them when they actually look at your base, especially Teslas, hidden Teslas, which you actually unlock them at a higher Town Hall level. So we'll talk about that in the future episodes too. So why are traps important is because they sometimes do help you out to take out the troops of the opponents, such as the giant bombs, which are really important. If I'm not wrong, you'll be able to get them at Town Hall 4 or 5. Which is a really nice thing to have. So now upgrading more of our walls, just using up the gold that I have, the excess gold. So whenever you have excess gold and you have upgrades to actually plan out to upgrade, you can spend them on your walls. And then eventually, once I reach to a certain amount, I stop there because I need like a few gold so that I could do some search to do some attacks. Eventually upgrading that gold storage over there, which require elixir to upgrade. So when you guys are going to upgrade a building, you guys should actually plan beforehand and also plan for the resources as to not spend all the resources, otherwise you won't have enough for your next attack. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video and do stay tuned for the next episode and clash on.